Hi, my name's Gemma Perry, and welcome to Mooncake. Hi, my name's Gemma Perry, and welcome to Mooncake, ESL teaching made easy. If you're new here, then you need to know that I make weekly ESL teaching tip videos to help you improve your English teaching. So if you're teaching ESL abroad, make sure you subscribe below and hit that notification bell for weekly ESL teaching tips. Also, real quick, happy Halloween. Don't be shy, let me know in the comments below what you're going to be dressing as this year. So it's Halloween and you need some easy games for your English class. Well, in this video, I'm going to share some Halloween themed flashcard games that require minimal prep. So let's not wait for the undead to start rising again and start with our first game, Monster Drawing. For this game, you're going to need a giant die, some whiteboard markers, and some flashcards of different body parts. Now, don't worry if you don't have flashcards of different body parts, you can simply draw them on the board instead. If you don't have a giant die, then don't worry, you can use a regular sized one. Start by positioning the class in a semicircle with you, the teacher, in the middle. Introduce those body part flashcards one by one, placing them on the board behind you as you do. Explain to the kids that you're going to work together to create a monster. Start with the first body part, for example, eyes, and have the whole class ask together, how many eyes does it have? Next, one student is going to come to the middle and roll the die, and whatever number that die lands on is the number of eyes the monster is going to have. The whole class then tells you it has four eyes, and you draw four eyes on the board. Move on to the next body part, roll the die again, and keep going until you've drawn a big, scary monster. Now, it's really important that we have the whole class asking the target questions together rather than one by one, and this is part of our classroom management strategy. If you're not sure what I'm talking about, you can check it out in my classroom management video linked below. This next game is a little more complex, but it's lots of fun for those students with a higher level of English. It's called Spot the Difference. For this game, all you're going to need is a bean bag and two sets of similar looking flashcards. So that's two sets of similar witches or two sets of similar monsters. Start by positioning the class in a semicircle with you, the teacher, in the middle. Go through the first set of flashcards one by one, reviewing the vocabulary and using TPR as you do. For example, it's a monster, it's a monster, it's a monster. Place those flashcards on the board behind you for the whole class to see. Next, take that second set of flashcards and place them face down on the floor in front of you. Split the class into two teams, giving each team a spooky team name. Ask one student from team A to come to the middle and throw a beanbag onto one of the flashcards. Next, the whole class as a group asks that student, what's the difference? And that student compares the flashcard in the hand with the one on the board, describing a difference between them. For example, this witch is big, this witch is small. If they're able to do so correctly, they get 1 point for their team. Next, student from team B comes to the front and they go again. Keep going until all the cards have been used. Real quick, if you're looking to join a supportive ESL teaching community, then make sure you check out the Mooncake English Facebook page for more tips, advice, and resources. Join the community, share your ideas, and let's work together to make English teaching easier. This next game is called What Do You Want To Be? And to play, all you're gonna need are two sets of some spooky themed flashcards and a sticky ball. Start by introducing that first set of flashcards one by one and placing them on the board behind you. Make sure you're using TPR to help students remember the vocabulary as you do. If you're not sure what I mean by TPR, then make sure you check out my video on TPR linked below. Next, draw three large circles on the board behind you and give numbers to each one. Split the class into two teams, giving each team a spooky team name. Next, take that second set of flashcards and pick one card without letting students know which one you've picked. Explain to the class that you have picked your Halloween costume and that they have to try and figure out what you want to be for Halloween. Next, a student from team A comes to the middle and throws the sticky ball. Depending on where that ball lands determines the number of points that that team can win. Next, the whole class as a group asks the question, what do you want to be? That student in the middle then gets to guess what you want to be for Halloween by asking the question, do you want to be a vampire? If they guess correctly, they get points for their team. If they guess incorrectly, they sit down and a member from team B comes to the middle and we go again. keep going until everybody has had a try. So there you have it, some easy Halloween-themed flashcard games that you can try in your class tomorrow. If you found this video helpful, let me know by commenting the word helpful in the comments below and by sharing with your fellow teachers. That's it for this video, thanks so much for watching. You can follow me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, and if you're interested in a Mooncake sweatshirt or mug, you can check it out linked below. And of course, remember to hit that subscribe button and notification bell for more weekly ESL teaching tips from Mooncake.